there are several areas of good news. The first is we have wonderful meds that treat and control this disease. When I started, people died of AIDS. That's what happened. Now they live normal and full lives, provided they take their meds. And by taking their meds, they really are very unlikely to spread it to anyone else. The other great news is that we have the medicines and the capability to prevent people from getting HIV and ultimately ending the epidemic. That includes taking meds when you're infected, and for those who are at risk but not yet infected, taking a one-pill combination along with behavioral counseling to prevent getting infected. Those two together should put an end to the epidemic. Now the bad news. The bad news is that these meds are not necessarily available across the world, and there are still many resource-challenged countries that are struggling to get the drugs into people. There's also a challenge in that not all physicians are aware that pre-exposure prophylaxis, or PrEP, is so highly effective, and there are some patients perhaps embarrassed to ask for it, that it's underutilized. And of course, the one-pill combination is somewhat expensive. So that, I think, is the challenge and the downside. The really good news on the horizon is that people are looking into, and drug companies are now in phase two trials for drugs that could be injected perhaps once a month or once every few months in the clinic under observation, so there's no way to miss your drugs. And then you get your injection and you're good for a month or two, both for treatment and for prevention. I'm very optimistic. We have the tools now. We can do this.